Receiving that, sit back, relax. I think we got about 17 sets. We have a good celebration. We're going to crank her open here. We got Mr. Sam Younger here on the table, and I'd like to mention that Sam Younger was one of the original Rackin' Sackers in 1963. And I tell you what, he's been around a lot, and you see, he's good. We got Miss Jed Butler to dance it up.
Down the Arkansas, 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 down Well, the Greek Arcade is named for corn out of the Arkansas. Fate shall pass the day you're born down in the Arkansas. Well, we court them gals with a beer tea high down in the Arkansas. Keep my court till the day we die way down in the Arkansas.
Down in the Arkansas, down in the Arkansas, down in the Arkansas. Prettiest girl I ever saw was down in the Arkansas. Prettiest girl I ever saw was down in the Arkansas.
everybody a little bit for Mr. John Berkey.
I'm
this is Miss Linda Swafford on the bass tub. Let's give her a hand. Miss Matt Denver Brownson.
Thank you. sure am blue. Now here's the reason that I'm so blue. My loving baby and I are blue. Well, bye-bye, look. Bye-bye, happiness. Hello, loneliness. I feel like I could die. Bye, my love, goodbye. I'm blue with romance. I'm blue with love. I'm blue with dawn. Those stars above. Now here's the reason that I'm so blue.
Break somebody. hours were never so lonely. My eyes were never so strange from watching and waiting and crying for you and hoping you'd come back again. Me and my heart and my lips and my arms, we miss you every day you were gone. Me and my heart and my lips and my arms, we miss you and we're glad
tonight. Thank you.
Thank you, Becky. Good job. And my favorite song, too. Well, let's see. Junior, I believe we're having the Rockin' Sack meeting about next Monday, ain't we? 25th. Anybody interested in joining, it's only $10 a year. And I tell you what, you can't beat that stick. We eat and have a little meeting, short meeting, then we just big grin and fellowship. You don't have to play or sing to be a member. And Jimmy started this club way back in 1963. And so if you're interested in it, see me or Dee in the back there, and we'll fix you out. Let's make Mr. Junior Fox welcome.
All right. Don't get around and play well, so get it hard. All right. Got my buddy Sal Younger with me tonight, so hit it in big chorus. Song in 1924, so that song's been around a while. That's basically the way he done it. Put it in A chord, and this new one the Manor Mountaineers made a hit on called It'll Be Change Up and Business All Around. Think it's nothing but a pride. What goes on here each night? What's going on right here in our hometown? Them same old girls get grown, and I'm mad them stay at home. Every night.
Just make me stand it up, you will.
Hi, everyone. Mail Worm Play on March Tree, Virginia.
Thank you. your mother cold and cloudy, sunshine made her cry. Sometimes still.
You know, we know a lot about the Revolutionary War. We studied in school. And we know probably even more about the Civil War. We probably list several generals and battles and so on and so forth. But there was a war in between that we don't know too much about. We know it happened. It was the Mexican-American War. And it's unfortunate that we don't know too much about it because the state of Arkansas figured very heavily in that particular war. It was 1848. The army was in Mexico fighting the Mexicans, and they were in trouble. And President Polk called for volunteers to ride to Mexico and help the army out. And there were about 450 mounted volunteers from the state of Arkansas under the command of a Colonel Archibald Yell, who rode to Mexico to help the army out, join the army. Now, Colonel Yell was well known at that time. He was our first representative in Washington, and he was the second governor of the state of Arkansas. Well, they got to Mexico in time to fight the Battle of Hacienda Sierra Vista. And at that time, the American army in Mexico numbered about 4,700 people, including the volunteers. And they were facing a Mexican army of over 22,000 Mexican regulars under the command of General Santa Anna. Now, he was the same general that about 10 years before was paroled by Sam Houston in the Battle of Texas Independence. Well, the general saw that they greatly outnumbered the American army, and so he ordered his crack cavalry corps, the Lanceros, to the Lanceros to ride around about 2,000 strong to ride around behind the American army and attack from the rear. Well, Colonel Yell saw what was happening, and he knew that if that Mexican cavalry had got to the rear of the American army, it would be disastrous. And so he quickly rounded up about 250 of those Arkansas boys, along with some Tennessee boys and Kentucky boys, and they wheeled and formed a wedge, and they went full speed at that Mexican cavalry with sabers flashing. And they hit them so hard, and they fought so fiercely that it wasn't long before they demoralized the Mexican cavalry, even though the Mexicans still outnumbered them, and the Mexicans retreated back to their own lines. And when the rest of the Mexican army saw what happened to their crack cavalry unit, they lost heart of the fight and turned and started a general retreat to the south, handing the American army the finest victory that it ever had against such overwhelming odds. Unfortunately, Colonel Yell died in that battle. He fell and died a hero's death, pierced by many Mexican lances. But we remember him today in the town of Yellville, which is a little to the northwest of us, Yell County, which is three counties to the southwest. As an interesting sidelight, there was a young artillery officer in that battle who, although he did not fight with the Arkansas boys, he still distinguished himself greatly in that battle. His name was Captain Robert E. Lee. I'd like to play a song for you right now, Los Peregrinos, to kind of remember and honor the memory of those great Arkansas volunteers who saved the day that cold February day in Mexico in 1848. Los Peregrinos.
Mm-hmm. to the northeast, to Ireland, and play a song that I think is one of the prettiest Irish songs I've ever heard. It's called Carrickfergus, several hundred years old. Very briefly, it's about an old Irishman who's been a heavy drinker all his life, as I guess some of the Irish are known for. And he sees the end in sight, and he wishes he could see his boyhood home of Carrickfergus before he passes away. Now, I guess 400 or 500 years ago, Carrickfergus was a separate village. Now, I'm told, it's really nothing more than a kind of a subdivision or a part of Belfast. Anyway, it's a pretty song. I hope you like it. Nobody does nostalgia quite like the Irish. Carrickfergus.
Thank you.
Thanks, Sam. Our next performer is Ryan Taylor, who usually plays drums here. He's got an injured hand in tank tonight. They have a show, Saturday Night Gospel, up at the Back Street Theater. And they're part of Revelation 7. I tell you what, go check them out there. You enjoy it, I guarantee you. Let's make Mr. Russ Hawks welcome.
I'm going to do a couple of songs that we haven't practiced much, but we'll get them packed someday. First one is, send me the pillow you dream on. Unusual barn. One following is Slowpoke.
here, life's railway. Life's railway to heaven.
Thank you, John.
Thank you.
Sharing so well.
Thank you. 49 years.
Let's make Vicki and Bert welcome. They're from Louisiana.
Me and Vicki have been driving all day. And the wives, they came with us, so they've been driving too. We're going to do a little Cajun song for you, first of all. We'll see if you recognize it. Hang on, I'll open it right with it. And when I nod to you guys, I'll take the lead, okay?
Goodbye, Joe. We gotta go, the old man. We gotta go, oh, the old man. I lost this one, the old man. Son of a gun, we will never be fun. Oh, goodbye. Just to take my mother's
driving easy, driving smooth, for the life that you're holding is the one that we love so to serve beyond.
Of the rings glad I have learned a good teaching. I'm so glad.